So today we're going to talk about what to do for ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. It's not genetic. Okay, there's no evidence or proof that this is a genetic problem. In fact, this might surprise you, but it's not a Ritalin deficiency. And from my viewpoint, it's not even a mental disease. This is purely a nutritional deficiency. The symptoms are low attention, focus, you can't focus, hyperactivity, restlessness, visual learning problems, difficulty reading, and remembering. Now, there's a great, credible study that I found that I'm going to share down below. It's not an observational study where they're doing questionnaires. It's actually a real study, 12-week, double-blinded, placebo-controlled trial. So check it out. And there was significant improvements in ADHD using high doses of something called EPA. Okay? Now, they actually use a combination of EPA and DHA, at least 750 milligrams of this combination every single day for 12 weeks. And this is very easy to find at any health food store or online. And I'm not going to get into any specific brands, so you'll have to figure that out. But if you have ADHD, you need to be taking this combination right here. If you can find one that's a little heavier in the EPA to DHA, that may work a little bit better. Now, what is EPA and what is DHA? Well, collectively, these are the omega-3 fatty acids. You have omega-3 fatty acids, and you also have omega-6 fatty acids. Collectively, these are called essential fatty acids. And what that means is that your body can't make them, they must get them from the diet. Here's the big problem. It's differentiating the importance of omega-3 versus omega-6. They're not of equal importance. Omega-3 is way more important than omega-6. Yet the ratios of these fats in an average person is 16 to 1, okay? So that's way too heavy on 6. In fact, over 100 million metric tons, and a ton is 2,000 pounds, is extracted and used in our food supply every single year, versus 4 million metric tons of omega-3. This is what's missing right here. Omega-3 fatty acids have antipsychotic properties. They help your cognitive function. They improve your IQ. There's over 170 genes that have to do just with brain development. They have the potential of increasing dopamine, serotonin, and protecting your neurons. So if you can imagine having enough omega-3 for your brain to work, you're not going to have these symptoms right here. Now, as a side note, if you have restlessness, or your child has restlessness, or even hyperactivity, I would add in there vitamin B1 in the form of nutritional yeast, or just some natural B1, because B1 deficiencies will easily cause these two symptoms right here. If your child has this, or you have this, start taking this combination at least 750 milligrams every single day, plus start reducing this right here, omega-6 fatty acids. If you're not familiar how to do that, I put a link down below with another video I did so you can be aware of that and you can start to cut all those things out of your diet. And once you do this, come back to this video and comment down below of your success. I want to hear it.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.